Greetings Simplicity. Today we have Dav Whatmore with us, a Sri Lankan-born Australian player and has coached many countries. Let us hear it from him. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for joining on our show. How do you feel India's position next World Cup?
Well, they're progressing as well as they can do at the moment. They're getting some valuable practice in England, because that's the venue, in 2019. They've done fairly well in the T20, the shortest format, and now they're about to begin five matches in conditions that they're going to find themselves in next year in the World Cup. They've also had some good results in the Champions Trophy, albeit a loss to Pakistan, which was not in the script. But it meant that they've been winning in England also in that tournament. So, you know, they're doing the right thing.
When it comes to calling a successful cricket team, what do you think is more important? Having a strong strength of bowlers or a ace batsman? And when it comes to Team India, what do you think is making the team stronger?
Look, you need both. Both departments have to be good. We haven't even talked about fielding, because that can often be the difference between two teams as well. Some people will say, look, in limited overs cricket, if you score one run more than the opposition, you win the game. Which is true. But in doing so, you've got to negotiate good bowling. And if you've got a good battery of bowlers, and I mean more than five, you need a minimum of five, then that makes that one run more than the opposition harder to get. So yes, there is it's very important to have a good, a strong, deep batting order without compromising your strength with the bowling. So both departments are very strong, are needed to be strong.
How important is fitness when it comes to cricket? And where do you think the Team India stands when it comes to paying attention to their fitness and performance?
It's very important. There's no question about that. The fitness for cricket is becoming more and more important because of simply the frequency of the physical strains you place on yourself with a series of matches. So there's no question, whilst it is a skill-based game, and unless you are available for selection from a fitness point of view, you are letting the team down. So yes, you need to attain a base level of fitness. In India, they're quite generous, I believe, when you look at certain levels that are required in other countries. Unfortunately, we've had one or two who've failed, but eventually they pass. But it is becoming increasingly important for performance.
Currently, you are coaching the Kerala team, and there hasn't been much representation from Kerala as such. How do you think that would go far?
No, but over the years, there's been one or two. Tinu Yohannan, Srisanth, Sanju Sampson of recent times, Basil Thumpke has played India A. But there are a number of boys who are knocking on the door, and you only knock on the door by performing domestically for your own state team, and that's what our focus is with Kerala. The more you can be consistent with your performances for your state equals getting that BCCI star on your cap when you get rewarded for those good performances.
Cricket then in 1979 and cricket now, how do you see it?
Woohoo! Totally different. Totally different.
All right, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for giving us a deeper insight into cricket. Thank you.
Thank you.